A lot of people have been asking me to respond to Stefan Molyneux's videos, and I've been saying, yeah, they're like hours long and I'm lazy, and that's true. That's not really the whole story. Now, I'm not going to respond to any of his videos or indeed any point that he has ever made about anything. What I'm going to do in this video is just tell you what he's doing, how he's doing it, and what to really look for if you want to spot what he's doing. Maybe, you know, if you have the ability and willingness to see it, you will. If not, you won't. But I'm just going to throw it out there because this video is the least I can do. But it's also the most that I will do. Now, what Stefan Molyneux really does is a style of slow, methodical mental reprogramming. Now, I've seen a number of variations of this, and the very first one was in the book Dianetics by L. Ron Hubbard. Don't watch me wipe my nose. Okay. And here's basically how it works. It's actually brilliant. What he'll do is make you take little logical leaps, right? Just one little leap at a time, move over another leap, move over another leap, come back and reinforce the first. The way to look for this is he'll take something that's a known reality, but he'll state it in a specific perspective on that, a specific way of looking at it, or a specific inference drawn from it, and then he will repetitively reinforce that. Now, he'll go about it in a number of different ways, but each one has an emotional reinforcement. And, you know, to say, like, this is obviously so. Move on a little bit, quickly go from topic to topic in a way that confuses the listener, come back, reinforce it a little bit more, because while their mind was distracted by the stuff that he is talking about, it got cemented a little more firmly in their mind, turning the reality and the perception of that reality or inference of that reality into a single thing. And so, one by one, he just creates these points of things you know. And, I mean, really look for that. Look for when he's repeating himself. I mean, he really does it a lot. He'll get one point, repeat, repeat, give some examples. You don't know if those are bullshit. A few more examples. Nah, that sounds plausible. Yeah, move from topic to topic. Come back and reinforce it as if it were a fact. Then, he makes sure that actually within the context of these programmed perceptions that his logic is self-consistent. And that's one of the things that makes it so very difficult to argue against him. Because if you've had these precepts programmed in this manner, well, his logic is actually flawless. And if you find a contradiction as an outside observer and point it out, then one of the people who has this programmed in, they'll be like, no, no, you don't understand. You're not getting it. You see this? So you can't argue against the logic, but what if you start arguing against one of these points of programmed perception? Well, there's a whole network of them in a logically consistent network. So let's say you attack one of them. Well, you might. Maybe even if you sway the person a little bit that there's another way of looking at it, as soon as you stop, there is an entire network of pre-programmed points of perception that will absolutely make them forget that, because the brain does not like cognitive dissonance. And you can attack each one of these programmed points of perception at a time, but as soon as you move on to the next, the first one has restored itself in their mind to maintain mental homeostasis. One second, let me think about this a little more. I think I can explain it better if I just focus. Ah, fuck it. And this video is really not for people who are already fans of Stefan Molyneux. This video is for people who are thinking about listening to him, just so you know what to look for. Now, people have varying degrees of susceptibility to this type of programming. Like, each one of these little assumption leaps that he makes you take. Like, you go there and you forget, like, your brain can keep count of the number of assumptions that you make in believing something to be true, right? And some people's brains are better at this than others, and it has a lot to do with both, you know, like an intrinsic mental property, their education, their circumstances, their emotional state, etc. But most people, they listen to Stefan Molyneux, and their brain keeps track of the number of assumptions they make. And while they can't actually say specifically how they know it's bullshit, they do know it's bullshit, because a sense builds up in their mind, like, they know the number of assumptions that have been piling up. They aren't distracted by his, you know, thing. Now, because a person doesn't know exactly why it's wrong, now they object to any one point, saying that's not true, here's the facts. Well, because that person has their own entire logical construct that's self-consistent in their own mind, what they say, it builds this image of Stefan a little more, like, see, Stefan really is a genius. He understands things to an extent that nobody does. He is a brilliant visionary. But what they don't realize is that insight is predicated upon the alterations that he has made to their perceptions through a slow and methodical process. And, I mean, I don't know if he has an ultimate goal. But his goal, proximal or otherwise, is obviously to have that, to have the adoration of others, to be perceived as some kind of insightful genius. And, I mean, really, there's no arguing against it, because, like, I mean, it's an ironclad method. So, I'm not gonna talk about Stefan Molyneux. I'm not gonna do anything refuting his videos, because, you know, I don't get on a moral high horse, and I'm not gonna do it here. And I say that I don't hate people, and that's true. But on a deep fundamental level, I dislike him. Right down to the very core of my being. And I can't help those people he has in his thrall. But I can help myself. I don't have to expose myself to that. So, gentle viewer, as one of my favors, will you please mirror this video endlessly and post it everywhere that Stefan Molyneux might find a few new victims, so that those who can be vaccinated against it are. Thank you.